A lot has changed in 2 years. Look at you.
What do you want me to do?
Believe it or not, I want you to be free of this burden. You deserve better. And when this is all said and done, you will be happy again. You will be free from this.
But until then, my dead ex is going to possess my neighbor and ask for my help?
Leave Laura out of this, at least for now.
Then what should I do?
Deal with your visitors.
Can we come in?
Pencils down!
Since when did Valentine's Day become the fourth grade?
Just for that, Mr. Stewart, you can go first. Who is Vanessa's greatest enemy?
Brittany.
Brittany.
Oh. That was easy!
Oh. Ben, Gina's enemy.
Brittany.
Brittany.
Oh, well, that was easy too!
Okay, chatty Cathy. Who's Melanie?
Chelsea.
What?
Miscommunication.
It's just a practice point for you two. Next question. Tim, what is Vanessa's favorite band?
30 Seconds to Mars.
30 Seconds to Mars.
All right.
Ben.
The Killers?
Damn right.
Chad.
Foo Fighters.
Death Cab for Cutie.
Oh, really?
Honey, neither couple here has been dating for more than 2 months, and yet they seem to know each other better than our 6 months.
Arguing?
Minus three.
Switching sides now, switching sides.
Vanessa. Kim's
Gunderson.
Yep, Gunderson.
Whatever happened to him?
I quit. He said I wasn't cut out for the business world. Made some calls, tried to ruin me. No big.
He missed so much. Anyway, Gina, who's Ben's?
Becca.
Becca.
Who's Becca?
She's the editor at the paper. She's got it in for me.
All right, Melanie, here's your chance.
Why would you put Blake?
Well, who'd you put?
Well, no one.
Really?
I'm a nice guy, no enemies.
I don't think Brad Norman would agree with you.
What?
Who's Brad Norman?
No one.
Which is what's on the card, so if you and Ben were dating, then we'd count it. Sorry, Mom.
What a shame, you're not doing so well.
Now, Vanessa, is Tim an improvement from Zach? Or is that not a fair question since Zach's probably dead?
Come in.
Who are you?
A friend of Chris's.
And Sarah's? I don't remember seeing you in my little picture show. Then again, I did cut those short.
So you stopped having her memories?
Well, I stopped seeing Sarah, so I stopped having her memories.
That's good. There's something you should know. Someone's trying to kill all my friends, and I'm trying to stop them. It's what I've been told I'm destined to do.
Okay, Mr. Destiny. Well then, what does that make me destined to do?
Stay away from Blake.
Why?
Blake's doing this. He murdered 7 people.
Why did you bring him here?
You said you wanted to talk to him, and you were supposed to come back, but you never did.
Sorry, something came up.
Well, do you think he's the killer?
I don't know, but Zach seems to think...
Zach?
What about Zach?
You tell me.
I don't know what happened, but he's dead, isn't he?
I wasn't there when he disappeared.
What is going on?
Blake, why did you come here?
He came to see this girl he met here. Her name is...
Laura?
You know her?
How could I not? She looks exactly like Sarah.
What?
She's real.
How can Blake be a killer? He just... seems so...
drunk? He's blocked everything out, and he's violent. He pulled a gun on me, and I'm pretty sure he doesn't know what happened.
So what? He thinks you're dead?
He has to. He's a murderer, and if he knows I'm alive, then...
But he doesn't remember.
That doesn't mean he didn't do it. I've been spending the last 2 months piecing everything together about the deaths that have occurred. Blake was drunk for every single one of them.
So?
So I've also been talking to a psych grad student, and she says it's a possibility that Blake could be doing this.
But Blake, he just seems like such a nice guy.
He's not. Stay away. Stay away from all this. Trust me. It's for your own good.
This isn't possible.
Well, you should go see her.
Why?
Because he's in love with her.
I don't think he's capable of love.
I didn't think I was either, but then I met her. I thought everything could change.
Well, it didn't.
Well, this could be my second chance. I need to find her.
It doesn't want you to.
What is going on?
It doesn't matter. I'm going.
Don't even think about it.
What are you?
This is the first time you felt like you deserved to see me, so listen. This girl, Laura, she may very well be the girl of your dreams, but what about her? She has a life that you will ruin. Stay away from her.
No. She may be my one chance to escape all this. I have to see her.
Look, if this is about what Ben said, I don't know what he's talking about.
It's not. But you never seem to know what anyone's talking about.
It's not true. I love you.
No, you don't. As much as I want to believe that, we're just using each other. It's worked up until this point, but I don't think it can anymore. I mean, it's Valentine's Day, and I've never felt so alone.
You want to break up?
There's someone out there that wants to be with me, but it's not you.
Where are you going?
To find out your connection to Chad.
I don't have a connection to Chad.
Well, as a journalist, I think you'd be able to lie better. Then again, you have been hiding the truth from me for quite some time now.
Gina.
Ben, we're through. But you know this is important to me, and for some reason, you're just getting in the way. I can't trust you, and I don't want it.
All right, let's see. Two boxes checked. Let's get the third one checked so I can go home. Okay, just because Gina and Melanie can't handle their relationships doesn't mean that I can't.
Do you even realize how many people you've slept with? A lot. And let me tell you something that my good friend Azazel has informed me of. All of us are destined to be alone.
That's not true.
Tim, do you even realize the only reason she's with you is because Zach disappeared?
No, I want to be with Tim.
And the only reason she was with Zach in the first place was because she felt guilty about sleeping with Blake.
When did you sleep with Blake?
It was one time 5 months ago.
We know when you were seeing the dead girl.
Oh.
Aaron, shut up.
No. My time is almost up.
What are you talking about?
I came here to help him one last time. But after tonight, I'm not sure there will be an after.
Is this about Blake?
In part. Yes, but what you're failing to realize is that Jenny's death started a chain of events that's spiraling out of control. And now there's no way out. We can't escape what's destined to happen.
And what's destined to happen?
Well, three horrible breakups, a sad realization for Blake, and a decision Chris will make that will ruin his life. Assuming he lives long enough to make that decision.
And how do you know all of this?
Fate is being corrected by two sides. Now, I'm not sure which side is right, but I do know one thing. We're disposable. We don't matter. Not in the big picture anyway. And, well, we've all ruined the big picture. In order to correct it, we all have to pay. One at a time.